Thank you. kills the moment of silent reflection.
Is it on? Yeah, it is. And I neglected to put in the wonderful harp player's name, and it's Cheryl Cunningham. She played for me about a month ago at Ambler, and I loved working with her, and she's fabulous. Thanks, Cheryl. Take a bow. What is amazing about the piece you just heard is that Faure didn't take a church job until he was at least 50 years old. He was, shall we say, no great shakes in the belief department. In fact, when he heard of some stuff that other people had written, he was scandalized and could not believe that someone would write something having on a Christian theme that would have something to do that would be that powerful. That's why I sort of sense a certain kinship with the first hymn that we did, the Where Do We Come From, because it seems incredibly in the mindset of what Faure wrote. The Sicilian that you heard that Diana played for the prelude is taken from a suite of music from incidental music for Pelléas and Malaison. And if you're of a certain age, you probably recognized it from one of the call numbers on the radio station when we had classical radio back in the good old days. That's a long time ago. Then the piece that Bob sang, En Prière, is about a prayer. It is still a secular song, however, and then the postlude that you'll hear Bob do again shows another site of Faure completely. I knew him predominantly as a writer of French art song. I had to keep saying to the choir, don't be too chaste with this, because Faure wrote a lot of songs, and they are all dedicated to different women. An opportunist or man or hopeful. Have a moment of silent meditation before we go into the second hymn, which is Breath, which actually plays off of the responsive reading that you did earlier on in the service.